Hello and welcome to this brief tutorial on transferring data to and from CHPC file systems in the case of small data transfers. If you have a larger data transfer, you will probably want to use a data transfer node or DTN just because it has higher bandwidth and it was designed for that sort of transfer, so it won't bottleneck anyone else's traffic on the university's network. It's important to note as well that you can use mapping for a file system to access your files directly instead of copying them to and from a computer, but this is in the case that you want to have two separate copies of your files, one on your local machine and one on CHPC resources. There are a number of tools that will let you do this. Some for Windows are Cyberduck and WinSCP. Mac also has Cyberduck, and it can use command line tools like scp and rsync, and those command line tools are also available on Linux. But this is definitely not an exhaustive list, and there are many other options available, so you should always do some research and find the one that best suits your needs. I'm going to cover scp, rsync, Cyberduck, and WinSCP in this video. SCP is a simple command line utility, and it's good for small transfers and things where you don't really have to rename any files or preserve any symbolic links or any more complicated task that you would normally do with a shell script, for instance. And SCP works over SSH, so the syntax is very similar, and in that sense it's really easy to pick up. Rsync is another command line utility, and it is a bit more robust. It has a few more options, like tools to allow for the interruption of transfers. So if something happens to your internet connection or the remote you're trying to push files to goes down or something like that, you can actually just pick up where you left off and not have to transfer all of your files. So this is better for larger transfers. And it also has tools to let you rename multiple files, and it preserves your directory structures and your symbolic links and all of that stuff. So I would generally recommend rsync if you have a more complicated setup that you need to copy over. Cyberduck is a graphical utility for both macOS and Windows, and it has a sort of drag and drop interface, so it's really easy to use. And it has multiple protocols available for transfers, including some that are based on SSH, so you don't really have to find your location on the file systems, if that makes sense. And then also WinSCP is very similar, but it's only available on Windows, and it also has a drag and drop interface and multiple protocols available. The first tool I'd like to talk about is SCP, or Secure Copy, because it's very simple to use and it's available out of the box on most Linux distributions and macOS. And really any computer that has SSH installed on it should be able to use this, because it copies files over SSH. If you're on Windows, you'll probably need to download a tool that can help you do this, but I'll cover that after I cover the command line version. So this is what you'll want to use probably if you're on Mac or Linux. SCP has a very simple syntax. It's just SCP, the file or files you want to copy, and then the file you want to copy it to, sort of the output file. And for either of these, either the input or the output, you can use SSH to copy them from another computer. So if you don't have physical access to your computer, it shouldn't be an issue. I do, so I'm going to just copy something from my local computer. I'm going to copy hello_world.py to the CHPC file system. So I can use SCP, the name of the file, and then the location I'd like to copy it to. And for this, again, I can use SSH, so I can do my university ID at any CHPC Linux resource, so I'll just do King's Peak. And then the colon character to specify a path. And you can either do for this path just a directory, so I could do that, or you can specify the file name itself, and you can actually rename files here. So I'll do this hello world renamed.py, and then I should be able to copy it over by entering in my password for King's Peak, which is just my campus password. And these errors up here don't matter. It's just something to do with the shell itself, but right here you can see it's copied it over. So the time it takes to copy it will depend entirely on the file size and your internet speed, but it is pretty fast because SCP compresses the files when it sends them. So just to verify that this has been copied over, I can do the opposite, and I can copy from the CHPC file system. I named it Hello World Renamed to my local computer. I can do Hello World Renamed to or something .py. And then I'll have to enter in my campus password again for the SSH here. And it has downloaded, so I can do ls and see it right here. If you wanted to copy multiple files over SCP, you could use a path to your files and then quotation marks with the file name separated by spaces. But I'm actually going to recommend you use just a directory with the files you want to copy in it and then copy it recursively. So I've created a directory named example here, which has four files in it. And if I wanted to copy all four of these files, I would have to specify the file names for each individual file, which is not something I would really want to do if I had a lot of files I wanted to copy. So instead, I can use scp-r, which means recursively, and it works in a similar manner to cp or the more dangerous rm-r, which will sort of descend into the directories and copy everything inside of them. So scp-r, my directory is named example, and then I'll copy it over to the CHPC file system, and I will name it just example directory. So I'll enter in my campus password again. And when this runs, you can see that there are all four file names now, instead of just the one. So this looks good. It looks like everything's been uploaded. And we can do the reverse just to make sure. So I will copy from the CHPC file system at example directory and copy it to example directory on my own computer. I'll enter my password again for the SSH. And you can see it's copied down all of these files again. And I can list my files and see that they are in the example directory. Rsync is a pretty powerful command line alternative to WinSCP, and it has some distinct advantages in that it has some very specific flags you can set, and it will preserve a lot of the file system structure that you've specified on your local machine. For instance, if you have symbolic links, it will preserve those. So if you run the rsync --help command, you can see all of these options you have here, and there's quite a few. So depending on your use case, you'll probably want -v for verbose, -c to use a checksum instead of the modification time and the size of the file to see whether it needs to be updated. Some other ones, probably -P if I can find it here. There it is, which will allow your transaction to be interrupted and then picked up at a later time. So if your internet connection disconnects or something of that to that effect, you can just pick up where you left off next time and it'll not upload everything again. So it's better for larger file transfers. So some flags I'm going to recommend are H, A, C, V, Z, and capital P. And then you'll also want, in some cases, the --stats flag. But here I'm just typing the command. It follows the same syntax as SCP. So you have sort of the SSH structure here with my ID at kingspeak.chpc.utah.edu. And you can see that it has now transferred. The speed up for this was actually 0.33, which means it was slower. And the reasoning behind this is that I transferred a very small file, and it actually had to send and receive more just to check that it was actually transferred wholly. It wasn't corrupted in any form, and everything went to plan. So this makes it a lot faster in the case of larger files, but not so much for small files. So I'm just going to check that it has been transferred here by mounting the file system on my own computer. And then if I list the contents, you can see that I do indeed have a sample underscore data directory here. So everything worked as intended. And you can go in the opposite direction as well and transfer files from CHPC to your local machine. When you first open Cyberduck, you'll want to use the Open Connection button to open a connection to a remote host so you can transfer your files. There are a number of protocols you can use, but the easiest are probably going to be SFTP or any other SSH-based file transfer protocol. And that's because you can connect to a server like Kingspeak instead of the file server itself, just on the default port 22 here for SSH. And you can sign in with your campus ID and password. You can also use SSH keys, but if you just need to do a quick transfer, it's probably easier just to use your password for this. So I'll click connect here. I get a notification that a connection has opened, and I can see all of my files here from the CHPC file system. And if I wanted to copy over some of my files, I could click the upload button here and choose my files and click choose. And then I'll probably have to enter in my password again. It'll prompt you every time you have a transaction unless you click the save password button. And sometimes it asks more than once. So it might be better to click the save password button. And my files are now on the remote, and I can actually edit them here with the context menu, and it just opens it in Notepad. And there it is. So I can also download these just by clicking download or download as to change the name of the file. But that about covers it. You can just close this by clicking the disconnect button in the top right. WinSCP supports a number of file protocols, but the easiest are probably SFTP or SCP, because you can connect to a computer like kingspeak.chpc.utah.edu instead of actually connecting to the file server, and this just uses your university ID and password, and it works over SSH. So you can see now that I have both my local computer on the left here and the remote on the right, and I can upload documents and open them actually in a built-in editor. And similarly, I can download them with the download button in the top here. You can actually rename files when you do this, and you can use the wildcards to rename in bulk. So I now have the two additional files on my local machine. There are a lot of options in WinSCP as well. At the top here, you can change your directory, refresh the view. You can actually delete files from this view, and it just takes some playing around with, but that's basically how to do it. And you can disconnect by just closing the window. I hope this video was helpful. If you have any questions or you'd like to suggest a video topic, please email us at issues@chpc.utah.edu or stop by our offices in INSCC 405. Thanks for watching.